We're going to see how we can control the position of a servo motor, something like this, using a variable resistor or potentiometer. We already know how to measure the voltage of this variable resistor or potentiometer using analog input, and also we have seen how can we set the servo at any angle between 0 to 180 degrees. Now we are going to control the servo using this potentiometer. Now, because we are using two devices, this needs 5 volts, and I want to connect this to 5 volts. Because I have only one 5 volts in my Arduino, I have to define a pin as an additional 5 volts. And if you're using this type of Arduinos, you don't have to do it. You can just connect it to the second 5 volts. This is one, and that's the second one. Here is the schematic diagram for the servo with potentiometer. The servo has a positive, which has been connected to 5 volts. The negative is connected to the ground. The pulse is connected to pin 3. And this is our variable resistor. From one side, it's connected to 5 volts. This D2 has been defined as 5 volts in our program. The other side of this is connected to the ground. The middle one, which is changing, we are reading it at analog 0. And here is the wiring diagram. From the servo, the signal pin is connected to pin 3 because this has a pulse width modulation. The positive is connected to 5 volts, the middle one. The last one is connected to the ground. From potentiometer, the left side pin is connected to the ground. The middle one, which is a value that we are reading, is connected to analog 0. And the right pin is connected to pin 2. This is a 5 volts or VCC that we have defined in our code. Let me show you the wiring. The servo has the three wires that I've shown you before. The left wire is the ground, have been connected to the ground of Arduino. The middle wire is red, connected to 5 volts. And the last wire is orange here. It has been connected to pin 3. This is my potentiometer. The left pin, because I want this one, when I move it to the left, I want it to be 0. So this is connected to ground. And the right pin has been connected to pin 8, which acts as our VCC2 or extra 5 volts. And the middle pin, the red one, have been connected to analog 0, where we read the value of this. Let me explain the code. As before, this is part of the library. We are defining an instance of this class, and this is an object, my servo. You can change it to some other name if you wish. And after this, we define a pot pin or potentiometer pin analog 0. So instead of A0, we will be using this in our code. And then we define servo pin, pin 3, which the signal pin of servo will be connected. And I'm creating VCC extra 5 volts at pin 8 for potentiometer. This val is a value of a reading potentiometer, and this will be updated inside the code. Inside the setup, we define the serial monitor with 9600 baud and to display the text on the screen for us. And then we use this object myservo.attach to attach the servo pin, which if we define it as pin 3. So the servo is being controlled using pulse width modulation at pin 3. And this is our VCC. We say VCC2 as an output. So pin 8 is now act as an output. It's defined here. And then we go by writing digital write VCC high. This means the pin 8 will be always high. And high means 5 volts. So we have extra 5 volts in here. Inside the loop, using analog read pot pin, this is the potentiometer pin. We are reading analog 0 pin. The value will be stored in val. This is our variable which we defined above. And then we now have to translate the value that you are reading between 0 to 1023 to an angle. And this is a function, internal function of Arduino. It's called map. So it takes 5 arguments. For the first argument is the value that you want to change, and the value is this value which we are reading from potentiometer. You can enter also manually a number between 0 to 1023, so you get the value and you say the value. You have to also mention it, what is the minimum and maximum. Minimum is 0, maximum is 1023, and you want to map it to another value between 0 to 180, and which is our angle. What it does internally is when it's 0, it gives you 0 angle. When it's 1023, it will give you 180. And the other value in between, any value between 0 and 1023, will be between 0 to 180 proportionally. And the result of this calculation will be stored in the same val. Now the val will be replaced, so we don't have to define another variable. And then we use this a function called write, my servo.write, and then we pass this value inside this. So whatever is the angle, let's say it's 30, 40 degrees, will be here, and the servo will move to that location. And then we use serial print to print the value for us. Then we use serial print ln to create a new line. It just enter extra line for us, and then we wait for 200 milliseconds. The loop will continue reading it every 200 milliseconds. Here is a demonstration of the code, the same code that I just shown you. Now it shows that my potentiometer is at the minimum, and the angle also that is printing is at 0, and also we see that the servo is also at 0, and we can define our 0 whichever we want. If I rotate this to the right, you will see that the servo is moving proportionally, and this is my maximum value. And if you see here, the maximum angle is 179, it shows for us. So maybe 1 degree is left. And you see when it clicks, that delay is because of this 200 millisecond. You see when I move it, it jumps slowly. So if you want this one to be very fast, make it 50. Now I've changed this to 50, and it's reading every 50 millisecond. Now the response will be very faster. As you can see, we get very smooth movement.